What's up, everybody? Jason here for JaspysCaseBreaks.com. 2022 Panini Capstone Baseball just sold out. This is a 8-box half-case break. Two random teams each, number one, guys. It's a brand new release. All cards ship, and everybody gets two random teams in the MLB, guys. So it says 12 packs per box, 8 cards per pack. And then, you know, average box break, you get two autographs, two memorabilia cards, 12 hobby-exclusive base reds, two base golds, six hobby-exclusive luxury suite reds, and one luxury suite gold, and 12 inserts. So here's the dice roller, here's the customer names. Again, we're going to double up your names now because it is two random teams per spot. And then, of course, here are the teams there. So let's roll. 5 and a 3 for 8 times. Good luck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8th and final time. There you go, there's 8, Michael, down to Michael. Alright, 8 times, 5, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yankees, down to the White Sox. So Mike with the Yankees, Steven B with the Braves, Chris B with the Mariners, Dennis with the Red Sox, Mike with the Mets, Craig with the Cardinals, Dominic with the Giants, Chris with the Astros, Jeremy with the Phillies, Ed with the Tigers, Mike Gallucci with the Pirates, Michael L with the Diamondbacks, Marlins, Scott with the Twins, Ed with the Padres, Zachary with the Orioles, Jeremy with the Rays, Dominic with the Dodgers, Zachary with the Brewers, Ed with the Rockies, Craig with the Reds, Ed with the Nationals, Michael with the A's, Dennis with the Royals, Scott with the Guardians, Steven with the Angels, Jeremy with the Cubs, Blue Jays, and then Michael with the Rangers and White Sox. So, trade window is open, guys, while I go get the case if you guys want to trade. Raymond, every few minutes, Nightbot drops our link that opens up this Google Doc. If you're in a specific football break and you see that it's sold out, it should be here. And if it isn't, it's just because I haven't gone through orders yet. So there's no specific time slots. Whenever the break sells out, I go through orders. I put it on the schedule. So this is all I have for now. I got about another maybe 11 orders to go through. And if other breaks sold out, I'll add it to the schedule after 6:20 Pacific Standard Time. Of course, 9:20 Eastern. All right, let me go grab the case, guys. I'll be right back. I'm not sure, Mike. I assume that it's probably a product that was featured in Chronicles, like Capstones and stuff like that, Cornerstones. And we'll find out. I haven't actually seen anything today. I've been super busy all morning. So. Alright, I'm assuming no trades then. Let's close it. Alright, so the case is right here, guys. It's actually a very heavy case, actually. I did not expect it to be this heavy. It's like I'm picking up a Bowman case. Now, there's 16 boxes in here. So, we're going to open up the case. Let me see how I'm going to do this, because I was not expecting it to be this heavy. Ooh. All right, so what we'll do is we'll go 1, 2, 3 for the left, 4, 5, 6 for the right side. Dice roll it. And it is a 3. So 1, 2, 3, left side. So these here will be for number 2. Which I'll probably just post over here on this side. Just because we'll probably run another one of these later. It's probably a similar design. We'll find out soon, though. I wouldn't doubt it if it looks like other products they've made in the past or other competitor products. Just like their version. It's like copy my homework, but don't make it obvious, you know? Okay, here we go. If this product is really good, then you could see it stick around. Although I think Panini loses their baseball license, though. I think at the end of this year. I don't know how that's gonna work. I thought it was over in 2023, but I could be mistaken. Oh, you know what this looks like? This looks like Zenith football. You guys remember that? This looks exactly like Zenith, actually. Just a lot more base cards, though. Which they actually look kind of cool, though. Yeah, it actually does. And yeah, I didn't take one glance at this, guys. Not even, like, preview cards. Just whatever Nick has as the sell sheet. It's probably prone to getting damage. Surface problems, I'd assume. Suzuki. So, again, I think these reds and golds are, like, normal per box. I think a lot of these will end up being commons. What you're probably really going to go for is like the relics and the autos. Peak, Matt Barnes. Bryce Harper, Summit. Big Bang. Kind of gives you a little bit of a recon feel too for basketball. Julio Red. And Manuel Rodriguez, Crown Auto. Looks nice though, I will say. Showtime, Bobby Witt Jr., Glenn Otto, New Age, Siri, Deja Vu, little Trout Griffey. We'll probably randomize these unless there's a lot of them, and if there's multiples, then we'll just distribute out evenly, if that's the case, but we'll figure that out later. Whoops. Numbered there, Sean Manea. Numbered to 99. Velo. Insert. O'Neill Cruz. New Age Lubov. Ty France relic. and Seth Beer. Who's drinking a beer right now, guys? Who's drinking a beer right now? Carlos Correa Summits. And New Age Bobby Witt. I'm walking. Gonna have a lot of cards actually. Okay, next one. Alright, so there's a lot of inserts, and I'm assuming, like I said, a lot of those most likely will be like common ones. But of course, if you know this product a lot better than I do, and notice that I pass up a rare insert or like a case hit, please let me know. But everything will be shipping, so. And at least for the bigger names, I'll probably just be sleeving at least. Two autos, two relics. Numbered to 99, Yoan Adon. First auto, Stephen Kwan. Cleveland. I didn't run out of paper already, did I? Oh, I never clicked print. Yeah, that is Cleveland Scott. JP Crawford, dual relic, New Age. Bobby Witt, Crest. Manny Margot. Or Manuel Margot. Judge Big Bang. And Jake Latz. And it seems like the crest is like a one per box type of deal. So any of the bigger names like that crest, I'll sleeve at least two as well. Alright, next one. But yeah, thicker cardstock is probably the reason why they're all like 75 point cards, so it's another reason why it's kind of a little heavy on the heavier side. But it's a nice product though. Guess you just have to find out how loaded a case actually is though. Yeah, it does. It definitely has a crusade look to it. So they kind of took bits and pieces of different products they have created, right? Like you said, Zenith, a little bit of Crown Royale, and then kind of whooped up a new species. They're like Jurassic World, you know, how they're enhancing those velociraptors and T-Rexes. Next one, guys. Aaron Ashby rookie. Bobby Witt. Filetti. Connor Wong to 75. Benyon New Age. Jazz Chisholm, Peak Auto. That looks really nice, actually. Wander Franco, Connor Wong. Oh, did I pass the torque? I'm sorry. I generally probably didn't see it. I mean, I don't really have a sleeve or top load list, to be honest, so I'm just going to sleeve everything. If it gets top loaded, then it gets top loaded. If not, it's at least sleeved. New Age Carlson. Cruz. Bueller. And Rizzo Big Bang. This really reminds me of Recon Basketball. I was thinking, look to Echelon and look at a card behind it. Let's see. Oh. Yeah, I guess. I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty dead inside. I got out of here midnight. I had to pack up some stuff because we're moving two floors up in our apartment complex to a bigger unit, and I woke up at 6. I only literally got like, I think I went to sleep like at 2 in the morning. Got like 3 hours of sleep. and had to move stuff out. I even got some movers to help out some stuff, especially the heavy, heavy stuff that I can't do on my own. So yeah, I'm running on nothing right now. So I had to get a venti Starbucks
coffee.
That game was boring yesterday, Chad. Honestly. I was actually going to text you when Penix threw that interception. I'm like, who was he looking at? That first early interception? That game was boring, dude. Honestly. So boring. I was hoping it was going to be a better game, but you guys ended up winning, though, right? I mean, I think you guys were up by like a touchdown or two. I tried to pay attention to the Oregon game the other day while I was breaking. Ended up being pretty exciting towards the end. Cool little comeback. Mitch Keller. Love the card. I just kind of hate how the sticker pops. But still a hit there for the Pittsburgh. Bobby Witt. Kendall. Graveman. Trout. Matt Manning. Oh, so it ended up being like less like a touchdown win? Oh, yeah. It doesn't matter. A bowl win is a bowl win. Bobby Witt Crest. Torque auto to 99. Excuse me. And MJ Melendez. Dude, great season, dude, right? I'm saying.
Happy New Year, Jason.
All right, you too, man. See ya. Have you kept track, Chad? With Oregon and Washington winning, how many other Pac-12 teams have won their bowl games? Are we doing good in that sense? UCLA played their bowl game already, right? That Holiday Bowl, though, with Oregon was actually cool. I guess it's funny because they always used to play at Colcom Stadium or whatever it was called now. But I forgot they demolished it, right? And then now they played at Petco Park. It looked really awesome, though. Like, it only had, like, I think 36,000 fan capacity, but first football game in Petco Park looked pretty awesome, actually. I'd like to hit up that bowl game, like, next time. I would have loved to have gone to the bowl game, but it just landed in the middle of the week where it's kind of, like, kind of hard to call off, especially when we kind of already set our schedule, like, months in advance, especially during the holidays. But that was actually pretty cool. It looked it looked really nice. Although the field didn't look good though for the players. It seemed like a lot of the grass was just getting chunked up. Kuz got destroyed. No bueno. Dun 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 dun. Yes, I do remember that one actually. Who did UCLA play? Damn, that sucks. Mookie. Okay, well, I mean, if USC can handle business, I guess the top three did well, and then obviously you have the Rose Bowl. You have a Utah coming up soon. On Monday, so as long as the top dogs win, I guess, right? Bobby Witt. Patch auto. Excuse me. Edwin Arroyo. Peak patch autos. Akil Badu for Detroit. Dun 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 dun. Oh, UCLA. Does Oregon play against Washington in Washington next year? I'd love to go to a game there. I'm gonna go to Oregon next year, next season for sure though. I already told my cousin that lives up there in Portland. I told him I'll go visit him, and then we'll try to align it where I can go to a game in Eugene the same weekend. Byron Buxton. And it looks like there is a lot of those deja vus, so we'll just hand those out evenly. Oh yeah, you're right. You guys did play come over here, so yeah, it should be up there. Nice. I know, right? Let's go, man. I'm down. Ugh. All right, three more to go, guys. So again, this product looks nice. It's just kind of, you know, trying to get used to it. It seems, like I said, a lot of the same inserts over and over again. Seems like the crest is a one per box type of deal. And like I said, I'm just leaving up the bigger rookies if I don't miss any, of course. Just like Wander, Torque, Bobby Witt, Julio. Any numbered cards, of course, autographs, relics. Solid product though. I actually don't know how much it is per box, but two autos and two relics, you do get four hits, so in an 8-box half case, we're gonna dish out with 32. So on Ohtani, Trout, dual on card auto, pull save, and 5-star. I mean, I did pull that Harper Trout, but it was a redemption, that sucked. And then I Mike Trout patch autograph last night too. All right, here we go, guys. That's what I'm saying. Yours was live, right? Or the one you saw? It must be Bryce Harper. He just probably didn't sign. I think Mike Trout is hardly ever really a redemption. Peak, Alex Bregman for Houston. We have liftoff. Oh, Suzuki New Age, nice. Christian Pache to 99 for Oakland. Is that right, Chad? Nice. Let me know how the arena is, actually. I'm sure Kraken games would be fun. You're going to go to Kraken game, right? Dude, those tickets are so expensive. I had a customer named Jordan that buys here often, too. Not as much, though, but I'm still friends with them on Facebook. Jackson Coar. He was, like, on the wait list for years, right, when the Kraken... Or a couple years when the Kraken decided, you know, where they finalized everything. And he ended up, like, getting, I think, a pair of tickets or four seats. He goes, like, bro, like, I can, like, resell all these, like, and make, like, double my money. I was like, damn, that's crazy. I mean, Seattle's only really had the, like, Western Hockey League, right? WHL for a long time, so... I know there's a lot of hockey fans up there. So, I'm sure it'll be a fun atmosphere. Who do they play on Sunday? Let me know, Chad. We sell Kraken complete set boxes right here at the store now. I seen them the other day. They're like $10. Get your Kraken on. Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Josh Donaldson to 99. Julio. Michael Taylor. Because I remember last year you had told me, why the hell am I going to go see a Kraken game when they suck and overpay for it? Like, when the tickets were like hundreds of dollars. I'm like, yeah, you're right. But they're actually having a much better season this year. One of their top players, that rookie, they got last year, the number two overall pick. What's his name? I'm blanking right now. But he's having a really good season this year, too. Yes, I think it's Boehner's, right? Or, I'll look it up right now. Maddie Beniers, I think it is, isn't it? Yeah. He's having a pretty good season this year so far. And I think, like I said, he was the number two overall pick last year. No, he's good. And Islanders, New York Islanders. They're actually a pretty solid team, too. Islanders, recently, like, if you want to know, like, the hobby-wise, I mean, Sorokin was, like, a bigger Islander. He's, like, last two draft classes, the goaltender. I'm not actually too entirely sure who's actually really on that team now. I just remember the captain still has to be, what's his name, why am I blanking on some of these names right now? Matthew Barzell's on there. That's right. Looks like Alexander Romanov's there. Anders Lee, I think, is the captain now for the last couple seasons. Yeah. Seems like they still have Barzell. Like I said, Anders Lee, the captain. I still got a lot of their draft picks, actually. Bouvier. Oh, Zach Parise is on the team. I didn't realize he was there. Sebastian Aho? Is that... That's not the Sebastian Aho that was on... That's another Sebastian Aho, actually. Strategy is put it in the back of the net, Chad. And prevent it from going into your own net. And hit. Check. You walked yourself into that one. Nah, have fun though, man. It should be cool. Let me know how it is. Send me photos of when you're there, like of the how it looks like center ice wherever you're gonna sit. Cracking. All right, Peña. Trevor Story. Yeah, Sorokin's still the goaltender there. I think they also still have Varlamov, too. I think they have 3 goaltenders on the roster. Dylan Coleman. I know, right? Ready for a big weekend this weekend, Chad? You take your Bengals? I have your Bengals winning. A lot still to fight for, right? I mean, they're trying to lock up number one with a couple other teams. Kind of like the Eagles. Eli Morgan for Cleveland. Showtime. Bobby Witt. Yeah, I mean, it could go either way, obviously. Both teams are great. But I think Bengals should win, though. I'm a little nervous, though, for my Eagles game because I don't know if they're going to... I don't think they should play Jalen Hurts, but I don't think they are anyways. But, you know, it's kind of like one of those, like, games where the Saints obviously are very desperate because they have a chance at a playoff spot. And, you know, I think as long as the Eagles don't turn over the ball, it should be the Saints. But, I mean, look at those four turnovers last week is what happened. Still only managed to lose by 6, but that was the problem, those turnovers. Bro, I lost to Nick in semifinals last week. Look how much I lost by. We both had horrible weeks. I had Jalen Hurts out, and Nick, obviously. You know, I would have done the same thing, but he took Gardner Minshew from me and didn't even play him. Look how much we lost. Look how much I lost by. Check this out. Look how much I lost by. Look how much I lost by. I had so bad quarterbacks, I had to play Russell Wilson. Because we're in a 14-team league with, like, everybody just steals quarterbacks. Sad times, bro. Sad times. The reason why he won is because he got Parrish Camp. He got 3.9 points to beat me on Monday night. We both had bad weeks, though. Like, he had a lot of players injured, too. So it was very fair, very even, but he played Geno Smith instead of Gardner Minshew, which, if I would have played Gardner Minshew, I would have won. If he would have played Gardner Minshew, he would have won easily. You know? Michael Taylor. But, yeah. Now I'm fighting for third place now. Sad times. Yeah, PPR. Uh-huh. He had 2 catches for, like, 30-something or 21 yards, whatever. So he basically got, like, 4 points. And he beat me like that. Muncy. Yeah, it was pretty sad. But, like I said, the way we matched up, it was just competitive like that. But either way, we both would have got blown out because the other winners, 1-4, they both had 187 and 157. So if we would have played one of those guys, we both would have lost. But the way it matched up with us, it was kind of fair because of all the injuries. So, yeah, it was a little brutal, but whatever. I mean, I had a much better season than my projected. I was projected to come in, like, I think, like, 12th place out of 14. So, I mean, whatever. I did better than what I was supposed to. But the Jalen Hurts injury really messed me up, because that was, like, my golden player, like, throughout the season. I was getting, like, 30 points a game from Jalen Hurts. Alright guys, last box here. I don't know, I mean, I think Jalen Hurts has played himself into an MVP candidate and one of the top candidates, but I don't think he's gonna win it, honestly. I mean, honestly, I would. If Justin Jefferson went out and broke that Calvin Johnson record, I mean, I know it's a very quarterback bias MVP, but I'd give it to Justin Jefferson, honestly. I mean, he's had an amazing season. But, I don't know. I'd be happy if it's Jalen Hurts, but I don't know. I don't think they're going to give it to him anyways. But, yeah, I mean, Burrow's in the discussion now, you know, the way they've been playing. Josh Allen's always been there. You know, Patty Mahomes is obviously still doing amazing things. Patty Mahomes, though, is kind of, like, on that level of, like, Jordan. Not to say he is Jordan, but, you know, like, he's going to put up stats and stuff like that every single year. And it's going to be kind of hard to always give it to him. Right? Like, but he's going to be in the discussion for MVP, like, every season as long as he's healthy. Yeah, well, see, that's the thing. Justin Jefferson, I think, would have to break it. If he were to break it this week, I think they should give it to him. Like, but he would have to have an amazing season, obviously. But, yeah, that was the one thing, too. Like, A.J. Brown has an opportunity this week. I think he's only, like, 100 yards away of breaking Mike Quick's record for... Or Mike Quick or Harold Carmichael's like over like 1,500 yards in a season for the Eagles. So he would have to break it this week so that way there's kind of like no taintiness, like you said. Like, oh, well, they only had 16 games, not 17 games this year, so. Which is very doable. O'Neal Cruz to 25. But that's what I'm saying, right? Like, Mahomes has all the stats, and it's very amazing stats, too. So that's what I'm saying. You can easily give it to him, but I feel like you can always easily give it to him, honestly. The way he's been playing the start of his career, I guess. Whoa! Julio! Look at that! That's like an optic. We'll take that. Seattle Mariners. I don't even know who has the Mariners. Chris B. Buchholz. That's pretty sweet. I was not expecting that. I don't know how that was even in here. Is that a typo? Or is it in the checklist? And Colton Welker. Is that just an extra auto? Christian Yelich. Oh, it was just backwards, I guess. Jose Siri. Oh, I thought that guy had, like, no face. Bobby Witt. And there you go. Yeah, that was the one thing, and I get it's valid, right? Most valuable player has to be, like, you know, if he's not playing, you know, your team doesn't win, right? And Gardner Minshew's not a scrub. I mean, he can play in the NFL. He's, you know, was a starter at one point, right? But I just think that the Eagles I ultimately probably lost because he wasn't playing. You know what I mean? Like, yes, Eagles still had an opportunity to win the game still, shockingly, you know, and amazingly, against a good team like the Cowboys. All right, so Colton Welker, Morgan, Coleman, Badu, Pache, Kolar, Arroyo, Melendez, Wong, Jazz Chisholm, Otto, Lotz, Kwan, Manuel Rodriguez, Seth Beer, Julio, Jose Siri Relic, and then, of course, we have a lot of these Penny Sleeve Top Loader cards, including some Relics in here, too. So, I appreciate you guys. This is our first look of Capstone Baseball. Looks pretty nice. A little mixture of a couple products from Panini. But, again, the second half should be in the store. If it hasn't been posted already, I'll post it right now. JaspysCaseBreaks.com.